Good evening. Welcome to the Bible study. John chapter 21, verse 1 to 14. John chapter 21, verse 1 to 14. Afterward, Jesus appeared again to his disciples by the Sea of Tiberia. It happened this way. Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, and Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the son of Zebedee, and two other disciples were together. "I am going out to fish," Simon Peter told them. And they said, "We will go with you." So they went out and go out into the boat. But the night they caught nothing. Early in the morning, Jesus stood on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. He called out to them, "Friend, haven't you any fish?" "No," they answered. He said, "Throw your net on the right side of the boat and you'll find some." When they did, they were unable to haul the net in because of the large number of fish. Then the disciples whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." And as soon as Simon Peter heard him say, "It is the Lord," he wrapped his outer garment around him, for he had taken it off, and jumped into the water. The other disciples followed in the boat, throwing the net in full of fish, for they were not far from shore, about 100 yards. When they landed, they saw a fire of burning coals, and there were fish on it, and some bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." Simon Peter climbed aboard and dragged the net ashore. It was full of large fish, 153. But even with so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." None of the disciples dared ask him, "Who are you?" They knew it was the Lord. Jesus came and took the bread and gave it to them, and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time Jesus appeared to disciples after he was raised from the dead. This evening, I would like to share with you, love of God change your life. Can I say? Love of God change your life. You know, among the 12 disciples and one in the suicide, Judah suicided, and 11. Among the 11, 7 people, they gone to Tiberia, which is a Sea of Galilee. They used to be a fisherman, but now they left the calling of Jesus. They went to Galilee. Verse 3 say, "I'm going out to fish," Simon Peter told the other his friend. They say, "We will go with you." Can you see, Peter and the other disciples, in total, including Peter, 7 of them, from 11 to 7, which is almost 2/3 of disciples, they went to Tiberia, Sea of Galilee, and they catch the fish. But unfortunately, they caught nothing on that night. It's a good news or bad news? When they tried to catch the fish on that night, they caught nothing. That's a good news. Why? Because they run away from calling of God. When you have the calling of God, you have to live according to the calling of the Lord. But so many people run away from the calling of God. Don't depart from the calling of God. Keep the calling of God. Live according to the calling of God. Jesus asked Peter, "You will be a fisher of men." He should catch the fish. But he tried to catch, he should catch the people. But he tried to catch the fish. That is the main problem. That is why he caught nothing. They caught nothing. That night caught nothing. That is good news. If you run away from calling of God and try to catch the fish, there's no fruit at all. Early in the morning, they tried to catch the fish all night. They could not. They could have caught nothing. But early in the morning, next day morning, Jesus stood on the shore. But the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. You see, Jesus spent time with disciples for 3.5 years. But when they left the calling of God, they don't recognize Jesus. Can you imagine? It's how terrible if you're working for Jesus and you have a relationship with Jesus. But if you learn away from the presence of the Lord, you don't recognize Jesus. Jesus stood sure, and then they don't recognize. But Jesus asked them, "Friend, haven't you any fish? Jesus asked their friend, Hello, how are you, friend? No, they answered. You see, they heard the message of Jesus for 3.5 years. They spent time together with Jesus. They eating together, live together, sleeping together. They moving together for 3.5 years. But they, none of them recognized Jesus. In the last day, the love will be cold. Yeah, the love level in our life will grow cold. You know, they don't love one. They don't love Jesus in the last day. But these people, disciples, they spend time with Jesus for 3.5 years. They left the presence of God. And then he said, Jesus said, throw your net on the right side of the boat and you'll find some. You see, 3.5 years ago, when Jesus met Peter first time, he asked Jesus asked Peter, throw your net in deep side of the water. Very similar now. Jesus said to them, throw your net on the right side of the boat. And when they did, they were unable to haul the net in because of the large fish, number of fish. Jesus reminded them, I used to stay together with you for 3.5 years. But Peter rejected Jesus, denied Jesus for 3 times, even cursed Jesus. Every disciple left from Jesus. You know, if somebody reject you, if somebody upset you, disturbing you, disgrace to you, can you go that person with the love of God? This is the love of Jesus. Jesus came to them with the love of God. And then disciple whom Jesus loved, who is this man? John, Apostle John. We call the beloved John. And, you know, when Jesus had the Last Supper, John, he is the one to touch the heart of Jesus, or lay down the chest of Jesus. And what was happening? Disciple John said to Peter, It is the Lord! John, he recognized Jesus first. Why? Because he's the most close to Jesus. Do you recognize Jesus? John, his eyes open. And then the love of God touched John's heart. Love of God touched Simon Peter's heart. Love of God touched all the disciples' heart. And then when John said to Peter, It is the Lord. And Peter, he wrapped his outer garment and around him and then jumped into the water. Do you think he tried suicide? No. He was ashamed. He was guilty. He was so embarrassed, because he was a leader of the 12 disciples of Lord Jesus Christ. But he is the one to encourage the people, I'm going to fish. Yeah? I'm going out to fish. Then the disciples said, we'll follow you. And then Peter, he jumped into the water. And then Jesus prepared all the breakfast. When they landed, they saw a fire burning and coals there with the fish on it and some bread. Who prepared this fish and the bread? Jesus prepared the breakfast for disciples. Can you imagine? Somebody, these people rejected Jesus. They cursed Jesus. They left. But Jesus prepared the breakfast. Can you come? And then Jesus encouraged them, bring some fish you have just caught. Do you understand? They brought the 153 fishes, big fishes. And then Jesus asked them, bring some fish you can eat together. Simon Peter climbed aboard and dug the net shore. It was full of large fish, 153. And then Jesus said to them, come and have a breakfast. I believe that today Jesus wants to say to you, come, have a breakfast with me. Come, have a dinner together with me. Come, have a lunch together with me. Jesus wants to encourage. None of the disciples dare ask him, who are you? But they knew, everybody knew. Our beloved Lord Jesus Christ came to disciples and encouraged them and supporting for them. You know, Jesus reminded them, if you look at Luke chapter 5, Luke chapter 5, verse 4. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, actually Jesus borrowed Simon Peter's boat, and he was preaching, "Put out into the deep water and let down the net for a catch." And Simon answered, "Master, we have worked hard all night, haven't caught anything. But because you say so, I will let down the net." Peter remembered when Jesus spoke to him first time in his life, "Because you say so, I'll obey." And he catches so many. Well, when they had done, they caught such a large number of fish, their net began to break. So many. Do you remember 3.5 years ago, Jesus spoke to Peter and then John and James, even Andrew. Four of them. They are fishermen. You know what Jesus said to them? "Don't be afraid. From now on, you will catch men. You will be fishers of men. You will catch men." When Jesus met Peter 3.5 years ago, Jesus spoke to them very clearly, "You will be fishers of men. Now you will catch men. You will catch the people for God, for the kingdom of God." And you know what was happening? Verse 11. So they pulled their boat up ashore, left everything, and followed Jesus. They left everything immediately. Peter, he left his job, he left his family, and followed Jesus immediately. Can you imagine? Jesus reminded them, 3.5 years ago, when I met you, I called you fishers of men. You should catch the men. You should catch the people. But now, 3.5 years later, when I died on the cross, you guys run away from me. What's wrong with you?" But Jesus not condemn them. Jesus not reject them. Even disciples curse him and reject him, deny him. Jesus is the one to go to disciples with open arms. And then he say, "Friend, have you catched any fish?" They say, "No. You can't catch. Throw your net on the right side of your boat." And they catch plenty of fish. And Jesus say, "Come, have a breakfast." Can I encourage you? Even disciples, they're a little bit disappointed. We spend our life for 3.5 years with Jesus, but Jesus died on the cross. They thought we waste our life, waste our time for 3.5 years. 3.5 years, if you catch the fish and sail, and we may board another boat, another big size of boat. But we didn't. But we followed our master, Rabbi Jesus. They even themselves, they disappoint. When their master died, they lost the hope. They are hopeless. But there's good news. Jesus come to disciples. Those who are in hopeless and those who are in powerless. Can I encourage you tonight? When the love of God come to your life will change. Why your life not change? If you receive the love of God, your life transform. Do you know prodigal son? We know the Luke chapter 15 about the prodigal son, how his life transformed because his father's love. Father waiting for him. The Bible say when the prodigal son returned to his father saw him from long distance, and then he learned and embraced his son. Prodigal son, he was lost, but he was found. You know the amazing grace. I was lost, and I am found. Love of Jesus change your life. My prayer to God, Lord Jesus, let me experience your love in my life. Let me touch and change by your love. When the love of God come upon your life will transform. I'm telling you again, when the love of God come upon your life will transform. Disciples left Jesus. They're going out to fish. But Jesus came to them and reminded their calling. What was happening? they left their old job again, and they followed Jesus. When they followed Jesus, Peter, he preached on the street. 3,000 came to Lord Jesus. It's not wonderful. 3,000 people come to Jesus, come to the kingdom of the Lord on the street in Jerusalem when Peter preaching. You know, they saw the number fishy, 153. 153 fishes, big numbers in there, around 2,000 years of that time. But how many people? 3,000. So many. How? They return to calling of the Lord. How these disciples start a new life? Because the love of God, love of Jesus, touched their life and changed their life. If you experience the love of Jesus today, I'm telling you, you never run away from Jesus. Your need tonight, let me experience the Father's love in heaven. Let me experience the love of Jesus today, right now. And the love of Jesus touch you like a tenderness, encourage you. Your life is transformed. Do you know how God changed my life? By His love and His grace, He changed my life. I receive the love of God every day. When you receive the love of God every day, your lifestyle transformed. Disciples, they start a new life because of the love of Jesus. You know, when I working for homeless, drug addict, alcoholic, prostitutes, gangsters, all these people in London, many people, they reject me. Many people, they don't appreciate. Many people, they misuse me. But what should I do? I'm an instrument of gospel of Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus lives inside of me. I continually live the love of God for these people. Do you know how the sinner start a new life? When they touch by the love of Jesus, they start a new life. But my prayer for you, you and I, even I pray for myself, for Lord Jesus, I need more your love, more your love. Let more your love come upon my life. When the love of God come upon your life, you can start a new life. We need more love of Jesus. If you have an experience of love of Jesus, your life will never be the same again. You start a new life, powerful life, wonderful life. I think it's a problem in this world is a lack of love in this world. Many secular songs are singing about the love. People looking for more love. But Jesus, He loves us. Do you know what the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 8 say? Romans 5, I can read one more scripture and finish. Romans 5 verse 8. God demonstrate His own love for us in this love. He say, I demonstrate my love for you in this. While you are still sinners, Christ died for us. That is the love of God. When Jesus died on the cross, I'm telling you, when Jesus died on the cross, that is the love of Jesus. While we are still sinners, God demonstrate His love for us. Jesus died for us. Can you imagine somebody died for you? That is a great love, isn't it? Wage of sin is the debt. But somebody paid for your sins. His name is our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. He paid for our sins in the past and present and our future. Therefore, that is the love of Jesus. When somebody died on the cross, that is a great love. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You for this opportunity. I pray for my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus' name. Would You bless my brothers and sisters with Your love? By the love of Jesus, we start a new life. Disciples, they are disappointed. They are upset because of their master, Rabbi, died. Jesus died on the cross. And they went to Tiberias, Sea of Galilee. They become a fisherman again. But Jesus came to them. When disciples reject and left and they even cursed Jesus, Jesus came to them with the love of God. And then Jesus prepared the breakfast. Jesus asked them, friend, did you catch any fish? They say, no. Jesus already prepared a beautiful breakfast. Come and have a breakfast. Dear Father, we thank You for this evening. Jesus touch the disciples again by the love of God. And the disciples, they start a new life to follow Jesus. And Peter, he catch the vision of God, calling of God. He become a fisherman, fishers of men. And he catch the fish, catch the people, 3,000 people on the street. Father, we thank you. Tonight, we'll touch and change by the love of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for watching. And then God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you for watching. Be blessed. Bye now.